welcome everybody to Kollel Shira in partnership with Breslov Research, Breslov.org. And we're going to learn today in Yoni of Rosh Hashana, in Yonim of Rosh Hashana. It happens to fall into our regular Seder, which is Hilchas Beis HaKnesses, but Rav Noson brings in beautiful ideas of in Yoni Rosh Hashana. And we're letter Chaf Aleph. So we start off. Is there Bechinas Malchias, Zechroinais, Vishayfres? Huh? Right, Rosh Hashanah, right? Musaf, right? Everyone remember that?
Yeah.
Right, we start off with Malchias, right? Then we talk about the Zechroinas, right? And then we have the Shayfers, right? In that order. So let's see what Rav Noson says. He says like this, Malchias. Zeh bechina she megalin malchusai. Malchias is that we're megala, we reveal Hashem's kingship, yes, his dominion over the world. Hashem is the king of the world. Because Hashem is the one that created everything. He's the one that conducts everything. He runs everything. He rules everything. Everything. Right? It's upon us to praise the master of the world. To give greatness. Separations to the one that was created, the creation and created the world. Right? He spread out everything in the heavens. He founded the earth, the Olam HaSiyah that we're in right now. Then we're going back to the idea of the Chesed Chinam, that the whole idea of Rosh Hashanah, we're coming to the Rabbeinu Shel Olam, Kedalim, Ucharoshim, the Fachnu al Dalasecha. And we're like impoverished people coming to the Rabbeinu Shel Olam, please Hashem, we need Matnas Chinam. We need the Matnas Chinam. But then, Vayas, reminding Hashem, and showing Hashem's dominion over the world, And we state that it's all you, Hashem, and you are the king. Via us doing that, we can tap in to the Chesed Chinam that the Rebbeinu Shlom used to create the world and ran the world for 26 generations till Matan Torah. Now, Shuhun, okay. Shal Yedei Zeh, Nizgala Malchusa Yizbarach, through this, we reveal. We're making a revelation of the Rabbeinu Shlom's malchus and his dominion in the world via us coronating the king, which is the whole idea of Rosh Hashanah. Kikah b'riyas olam b'chasdai hu kidei legalis malchusai kayadua. The whole reason why Hashem made the world was in order to make known his kingship. Hashem made the world so that we should come to the recognition that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the king. That was the purpose why HaKadosh Baruch Hu made the world, so we can come to the recognition that Hashem is the Melech Malchei Amlochim. Nimsa, so we find, Shemalchias, who bechinas is galus hachesed shebay nivraylam. So the Malchias is, in that section of the Tefillah, when we come to Malchias, is showing the Rabbeinu Shlom's kingship of the world, and that in itself is revealing the Chesed Chinam that HaKadosh Baruch Hu used, and we're going to tap into that. V'ayidei HaChesed Chinam hazeh oisin derech l'Eretz Yisrael, and that makes our way to Eretz Yisrael. It's very interesting. Makes our way to Eretz Yisrael, huh?
What makes the way?
This concept of understanding that it's all HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and the world is really only Hashem's, so to say, on one level, trains our minds, what am I doing where I am? What am I doing here? If HaKadosh Baruch Hu runs the world, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu told us, we're going to see in a few minutes, he wants us to live in the land that's Eretz Zavas Cholav Dvash, right? It's the land that Tamid Eini Hashem Elekecha Bam Eretz Hashana Ad Achris Hashana. So what am I doing here? And another level is like this. We're turning to Hashem. When we daven, which way do we face?
East.
Why do we face east? Because we're facing towards Eretz Yisrael.
Right.
Right? Not all Jews in everywhere down east.
Yeah.
Some face west because it depends where
they are.
We're here in the north, we're here in America, so we face east.
Yeah, well, if you're in Europe, you have to face like southwest.
Exactly.
Or whatever.
But we're facing east. So again, and why are we doing that? Because we're trying to direct our tefillahs to Eretz Yisrael.
Right, right.
Why are we doing that? Because we need to get our tefillahs to Eretz Yisrael. And via tefillah going to Eretz Yisrael, and the Chazal teach us, right, in Masechta Brachos, that we need to get our tefillahs to wear to the Kodesh Kedoshim, because that's where the Pesach, where all the tefillahs go up. You need to get to Eretz Yisrael. Okay. Now we're going to get to Zichronis. So Malchus, it makes sense, right? Everyone understands. You're revealing the Malchus of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and by doing that, we can tap into the Chesed Chinam, which is what we so desperately need. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu views us and sees us in that way of a Matnas Chinam. Okay. Zeh Bechina Zichronis. Kikr Bechina Zichronis. The main thing is the Zichronis. Why is the main thing Zichronis? Who? We're begging Hashem, please remember the treaty that you made with Avram, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. V'yashiveinu l'eretz Yisrael, and we daven and we say it in the Shema Nesrei. We're going to say these words: Yashiveinu l'eretz Yisrael shu beis chayenu, k'may shekasav v'zacharti es brisi Yaakov. Vaharetz Esker, remember those words, right? We all say, right? Vaharetz Esker, remember the bris of Yaakov. Vaharetz Esker, remember the Aretz. What's Aretz? Eretz Yisrael. K'may shemesayim ha-bracha zoicher ha-bris. Right, we end off the bracha of Zichronis, what? With zoicher ha-bris. Tying the shoe, zoicher ha-bris, shekores as aveisenu la-shiveinu la-Eretz Yisrael. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to remember that treaty, that bris that you made with our forefathers to bring us all back, kibbutz galuyos, to come back to Eretz Yisrael. Valkein, Zichronis. Hu bechinas shemamshichin haderech l'Eretz Yisrael. This is also giving us the derech, the way back to Eretz Yisrael, because again, we're realizing this is where we're supposed to be. That's what we're saying in the tefillah. We're saying in the Zichronis, Rezeicha Abris, remember, to return us back to our land. Yeshiveinu l'Eretz Yisrael. Ayudei HaChesed. Now, then we go to Shoifres, right? V'achakach Oymri Shoifres. Shemidah b'mimatan Torah. Right? Shoifres is talking about Kabbalah Satayra.
Yeah.
Right? K'may Shoymri, Atta Niglesa.
Revealed.
You revealed Hashem. Haynu bechinas hamshachas hamoichin shehu haTorah. The drawing of our mind, the proper mind, which is Torah. Now, it's all year long we're stuck and we're busy with all the other things. When we come to Rosh Hashanah, the Shofar wakes us up. Right? Uru yisheinim mishinaschem, right? That's the Shofar. It wakes us up. When we realize it's mamish, the Torah is what we have to connect to wake us up from that slumber that we find ourselves in. That's what it means, coming mamish. Not the derech l'Eretz Yisrael, that's coming. That's, you know, I'm there. I made it there. I made it. Shebayin l'Eretz Yisrael. Maschilim bebrachas shofars mimatan Torah. And that's why we start Shaifers, we're talking about Matan Torah. Ata Niglesa. Right? We start off Shaifers, we say, Ata Niglesa, Hashem, you revealed. Umesayimim b'kibbutz nidachim l'Eretz Yisrael. And we finish the bracha, it should bring us back the final kibbutz galuyos to come back to Eretz Yisrael. They call us Shaifer through the Shaifer. We're waiting for the Tekabe Shaifer Godel. Right? We're waiting for that great blast. L'cheir Seinu. Please, Hashem, make it that we have that kibbutz so we can finally get back there to Israel. Dainu kibbutz kol ani dochem l'Eretz Yisrael. All of those that were pushed away, all of those nidachim, all of those that were pushed away, and all the meyaber kanfis arts to come back to Eretz Yisrael. Haynu kinal. Kabbalah Satayra, Shubachinas Amshachas Amaychin. Kabbalah Satayra is Amshachas Amaychin, where we were drawing the Mayach from the Yama Chachma. Right? We're drawing from the Yama Chachma, the Chachma Satayra. The love of Eretz Yisrael, ki Bechina, ki Heim Bechina Achas, she calls there, who Bechina's Kol Shaper. All of this is the idea of the Kol Shaper. So what do we say? That when it comes to, we come to the Musaf, right? Right, that's the climax of the day of Rosh Hashanah is come to Musaf, right? Right, where we blow the shofar by Musaf, we don't do it by Shacharis, right? And we blow it by. So when we come to the climax of the Tefillah, the Musaf on Rosh Hashanah, we understand with Malchias is what we're revealing HaKadosh Baruch Hu's kingship over the world, and we're saying that it's not what I thought, that it was this government or that government. This, I realize it's you, Hashem. You're running all these things. It's you're running it, Hashem. You're making this guy say this, and you make him say that, and you make these people do this. It's all Hashem. It's all HaKol Me'ez Hashem. And when once we do that, we're ready to get the Zechroinus, to ask HaKadosh Baruch Hu, please remember the bris, the treaty that you made with Brisi, like we said, the Vavav is Brisi Yaakov, to bring us, to take us back to Eretz Yisrael, to set ourselves straight, to understand what's important. And then we come to the Shofar. Uru Yesheinim Yishenaschem, the Shofar wakes us up from that slumber that we were in. What? What'd you say? No, yeah. Oh, wake us up from that slumber that we were in, because the shofar is like what we had by Matan Torah, and the shofar is what was able to bring us, wake us up by Matan Torah. We call our shofar, right? The call our shofar was so great on our Sinai, right? And then we hear the shofar to wake us up to realize what's so important, and we have to always make sure that we're doing the right thing, and we follow the Torah, and we follow the Derech HaTzadikim, and we follow our way back, Emetz Hashem, to Eretz Yisrael. Now, we can do Chav, we could do Chav Beis. We have some time. Baruch Hashem. Okay, Val Kane. Hey, my service, you made tshuva.
I gotta take
a note. Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah. So take over there. You made a tshuva. Kineged HaSeres, HaSara Mamorei Shebehem Nivroilam. The 10 days of repentance, right? HaSeres, you made tshuva, are connected to the Esa Mamorais that Hashem used to create the world. Right? Chazal tell us, for Esa Mamorais, Hashem was never a Soilim, right? Baruch atu Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam, Shehakol Nivra.
Amen.
Again, Shehem, Bechinas Chesed Chinam. Hashem made the world. Was there a Torah revealed? No. That was Chesed Chinam. Hashem ran the world for all those years. Sheikah Tshuva, who are Yedei Zeh? Our main tshuva is to connect back to the Chesed Chinam. We need to constantly remember the Chesed Chinam. V'alkein b'yom kippurim, shu soif haseres yimei tshuva. Right? Rosh Hashanah is the first day of haseres yimei tshuva. Right? And then we have Yom Kippur, the last day of haseres yimei tshuva. Oz nitnu aluchos achroinos, shem haseres adibros. Look at that, isn't that nice? When did Moshe Rabbeinu get the luchas? On Yom Kippur.
Oh, yes, but before that.
On Yom Kippur, Moshe Rabbeinu got it. Again, the luchas were what? Aseres Adibras. Esa Mamorais, 10 days of repentance, and the Aseres Adibras. Isn't that amazing? Ki Aseres Adibras, same kineged Aseres Mamorais. Why is there a Aseres Adibros? Because Hashem made the world Be'esa Mamorosh, and the 10 commandments are in lieu, are in parallel with the Esa Mamorosh. V'ika Kabbalah Satayrah u'kishem etzin ha'tayrah mehelam el ha'giloi. When we take the Torah out from Helam, from hiddenness, and we reveal it. Look, because before, the Torah was so to say hidden, right? We know that Avram Avinu, he kept all the mitzvahs, Yitzchak Avinu kept all of the mitzvahs. Yaakov Avinu kept all the Shvatim knew the Torah, and they kept the mitzvahs, right?
Yeah.
So what was different? But the Torah was Behelim. There was only a few that knew. It wasn't released yet.
Yeah.
You know, like today, they have something, they're working on something in technology, right? So they sometimes, they have it like they give out something to developers.
Yeah, yeah.
And then they have a day that they're going to finally release it. Yeah. Then everyone can have it.
Yeah.
But that's what the Torah was. The Torah was Helam. The Torah was just there for those very, very few. Taina Masha Betchila, Hoyu Aseres Adibrois, Shem Klala Torah, Nelomin Vinistorim Basorim Amores. The ten commandments were included. In other words, when Hashem made the world, the Esem Amores, the Ten Commandments were actually included in there, but it wasn't revealed. Bechinas Derech Eretz. Ba'yidei ha'tshuva. Sho'isim ba'seretz yimei tshuva. Through us doing tshuva. Right? In getting involved in tshuva, on ha'seretz yimei tshuva. Zoichin ha'mamshichin ha'seretz ha'dibra she'im klal ha'teira me'hela me'legiloi. So then, we get it. Did anyone ever think that Yom Kippur was another Kabbalah Satayra?
No.
Well, but obviously it is, because Moshe Rabbeinu brings us down the Luchas on Yom Kippur. On Yom Kippur, he brings us down the Luchas.
Yeah.
What's that?
It's
a Kivarecha. In other words, we only got the Yud Gimel Mim Disarachim because of the problems we got ourselves into.
Yeah.
Right? Shezeh b'chinei shebayim l'chol ha'eser. Next page, please. Eser kedusha shel Eretz Yisrael. Chazal tell us there are 10 different levels of kedusha in Eretz Yisrael. Anyone familiar with that? Yeah. So now we have 10, right? Here we have another 10. Look at all these 10s we have, right? And when we want to make a minyan, how many people we have to have?
10.
Hashem makes the world in 10 mamores, 10 utterances. Aseres Adibris is 10 utterances again. The 10 utterances of Aseres Adibris were included in the Esa Mamores, but there was Helam, and Hashem now revealed them. And then we have 10 levels of Kedusha in Eretz Yisrael. Shem Gam came Bechinas Aser Mamores, Shehem Bechinas Aseres Adibris, which is all one unit. Val Kainos, Beyoim HaKippurim, Nichnas HaKoyen Godol, Lifnai V'Lifnim, right, there's only one time a year that the Kohen Gadol was permitted to go into the Kodesh Kedoshim. Lifnayv and Lifnim. Only on Yom Kippur. Only on Yom Kippur. When? During the Musaf. That time, when he's during the Kabbonis.
Yeah.
And he was able to go in. She'oimed ala Evin Shesia. She'misham hushtas ha'ilam b'chazdai. The world, so to say, evolved out of the Evin Shesia, which was where the Aron was sitting in the Kodesh HaKadoshim, right on the Evin Shesia. Shesham Tachlis HaKadosh El Yoyna, that's the Tachlis, the purpose of all the Kadosh El Yoyna that the Evin Shesia is connected to. It's mamish connected on high. Shel Kol Ha'Esek Kadosh Shebe'et Yisrael. The 10th level of Kedusha, the highest level of Kedusha in Eretz Yisrael is the Makom HaMikdash, the place of the Kodesh Kedusha where the Evin Shesia is. Ki HaKol B'chin Achas, it's all one aspect. What's one aspect? Hainu Aseres Yimei Tshuva, 10 days of repentance. V'asara Mamares, and the 10 days, the 10 utterances that Hashem created the world with. V'aseres Adibris, and the 10 commandments. And the 10 levels of Kedusha in Eretz Yisrael. Look at those, nice how it's parallel, all these different tents. Hakol b'chinachas, v'chol kedushas elu, nigmorin b'yoyim ha'kippurim. All these Kedushas become, it's the climax of all the Kedusha on Yom Kippur. V'zoichin l'kabla ma'yidei ha'tshuva. And v'zoichin l'kabla because we were made tshuva, we're working hard during the month of Elul. During when it comes to Rosh Hashanah, which is the days of Aseres Yimei Tshuva, and through the days of Aseres Yimei Tshuva, and then we come to Yom Kippur. It's the climax of the whole of the high holidays. V'zoichin lekablam And then we're just tying back the lesson that we did before. It's through the chesed chinam from the tzaddikei emes, right? Because the tzaddikim, they are worthy to connect to the chesed chinam. And we learned before that what we need to connect to the chesed chinam. But what connection do we have to the chesed chinam? What right do we have to it? And we connect to the tzaddikim. That the tzaddikim have a right to it. And now I connect to the tzaddikim and they have the chesed chinam. So I too can tap into the chesed chinam. Via to sort of say to grab onto their coattails.
Yeah.
And that brings the way of simpleness and stand and earnest into the world. That's the way, the main way to come to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, b'pshitus, not the godless. HaKadosh Baruch Hu doesn't like godless. HaKadosh Baruch Hu likes pshitus. Pshitus, be simple. Tamim tiyem Hashem alakecha. L'cholecha v'echa mikol makim shu, wherever we are, but the main thing is to come, mamish to b'pshitus, to realize we want to connect to the tzaddikim, we want to connect to the chesed chinam, because via us doing that, we could realize the malchus of Hashem. Via realizing the malchus of Hashem, we can come to the zichrinus to remember the bris of that HaKadosh Baruch Hu made with Klal Yisrael, made with Yaakov Avinu, to bring us back to Eretz Yisrael, and then we come to Shofaris, and what does Shofaris do? It wakes us up from our sleep that we were stuck with all the things through the year. But now we realize that it's really the Torah, because the Torah was given with the Shofar. And by us listening to the Shofar, it wakes us up and we realize the importance of the Torah. We realize the importance of Yiddishkeit. And by doing that, in Mitzvah Hashem, we should all be Zeicha to have a Shnas, Gula, and Yeshua, and Refuah.
Amen.
Okay, so we'll finish with this.